Welcome back. Elise Campbell is going to the Dogs tonight. Now she's at the Black Dog for a little country roots music. Elise.
That's right, Michelle. We have the sounds of twang up on stage behind me here. Also, are you planning to go to the Edmonton Folk Festival? Because we have some guidelines that you will need to heed. Welcome to Wire. Good evening. We are coming to you live from the Black Dog, or Le Chien Noir to some of you more cultured types. We have the band Twang up on stage behind us here. Twang is a band that is very much getting back to the real roots of country music. You can just hear all the influences in their very upfront sound. Have a listen up. Twang as a group are not necessarily going to be headlining at the Edmonton Folk Festival, but some of their individual members are. I don't know if you caught him, but Ben Sears is back there. He's going to be playing at the Edmonton Folk Music Festival. Here are some of the other highlights and guidelines that you will need to follow August 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th.
On behalf of the Edmonton Folk Music Festival Society, welcome to our 1999 news conference.
The end of August will mark the 20th anniversary of the Edmonton Folk Music Festival, one of the most popular in all of Canada. This year, the Folk Festival is doing away with the 10 people or more festival pass discount. In fact, they're not even allowing you to purchase more than 8 tickets at a time. They've also increased the price of the 4-day pass to $85 from $80. Tickets go on sale June 1st at 9 o'clock a.m. at the Edmonton Folk Music Festival office and at Ticketmaster. And in order to reduce the number of calls the festival office gets at this time every year, they're really pushing their Folk Fest website at efmf.ab.ca. And in an art show to end all art shows, the students at the Victoria School for the Performing and Visual Arts are all collaborating on a performing art piece. It takes over the entire abandoned old King's College building, and it's kind of like a crossover between a playground and a haunted house.
This hallway area deals with alienation, so we have a number of installation pieces here. The one that we're looking at right now is the hand installation, which is the room where the mailboxes are. And so we have all kinds of hands who have characters who are beckoning us to find the pathway. This actually is a monologue written by a grade 7 student and performed by a grade 11 student, looking at insanity and sanity and the fine line between that.
I think I'm going crazy.
Actually, I have to admit, like, seeing all these exhibits, they're a little freaky.
Well, we actually,
am I supposed to be scared? Because I am.
We actually had a mother come by to pick up her child the other day with his two younger siblings, and the little boy said to his little sister, "Wow, this is just like a haunted house." And it's kind of not what we were going for, but I think our season is entitled Illuminating Pathways, and one of the things that we were looking for was, you know, what kinds of coping skills do we look for or do we use in finding our way through the dark passages of our life. Did you really
One of Edmonton's most treasured festivals is on the cusp of opening night, and this year promises to be the biggest. The organizers of the Local Heroes Festival are looking to really boost the festival's image. This year, they'll be featuring 50 films as opposed to last year's 5.
A lot of filmmakers going to be in town. There's going to be a buzz. We're at 2 new theaters over on the south side. It's going to be extremely exciting. And we're hoping to build this into one of Canada's major film festivals.
The festival kicks off Friday, and tickets are available at Tickets on the Square, Second Cup on White, Sneak Preview, and Alternative Video Spot.
Well, what do we have on tap for today? Holy cats. The Provincial Museum wants me to bring in 30 bears for their Christmas bear collection. Where would I get 30 bears from? It's not like I collect teddy bears or anything. Excuse me. Of course. Tim!
Nice to see you.
Nice to
what
see you
are you
too.
Doing?
Well, I got your call for 30 bears. It was hard work, but there you go. I think we got 30 bears. Dude, got another box in the truck there.
No, I really hate to disappoint you, but it's three bears.
Three bears?
Yeah.
No,
three. Seems like you've gone to a lot of trouble here. So these are all your bears?
No.
Bit of a collector, are you?
No. No, are you kidding me? Friends bears. I don't collect bears. I'm a grown woman. Yeah.
Elise, it's time for you to hand over your three bears.
Sure, Tim. Of course, I understand. I mean, if everybody brought 30 bears, they'd have bears coming out of their ears. Well, I think I'll choose the first bear, and a Christmas bear, and the love bear. And everybody else, they can bring their three bears here at the Provincial Museum on Saturday between 9:30 and 4:30?
That's right.
Okay, great. Thank you very much then, Tim.
Ready then.
Yeah.
Hand over your bear. Come on.
Maybe not.
It's time,
that's a love bear.
You must let go.
Maybe I should pick some other bears.
No,
Tim, no.